everyone, welcome to Krishna's online lectures. In this video of engineering mechanics, I am going to discuss about mass moment of inertia. That is another concept of moment of inertia. So let's start the lesson. So in previous lesson, I have discussed about some concepts related to moment of inertia. So what is the basic difference between moment of inertia and mass moment of inertia? So, if we talk about only this term, moment of inertia, so it is related to area of the plane lamina, as well as we consider dimensions of the plane lamina, and it is related to centroid of the plane lamina and the point where area of the lamina is concentrated. So, these terms are representing moment of inertia. But if we talk about mass moment of inertia, so as per this name, we can say this mass moment of inertia is based on mass, as well as we can also say it is based on weight of the plane lamina or weight of the object. Other thing we will also consider, we can consider volume, we can consider dimension of the object or dimension of the body or plane lamina. But here our main concentration should be mass. So this is the basic difference between moment of inertia and mass moment of inertia. Moment of inertia is based on area of the plane lamina and mass moment of inertia is based on mass. So if we talk about moment of inertia, so moment of inertia we generally define as the product of area into square of perpendicular distance, where the point where total area of that particular lamina is concentrated from one axis. So here if we consider one lamina and the area of the lamina is A, total area is A, and here if we define one point, let us consider this point is point G, and at this point total area of the lamina is concentrated. So first we need to define the location of this point G. So here if this lamina is placed in XY plane, so from Y axis we have to define the distance of this point G, and from X axis we have to define the distance of this point G. So let us consider X distance from axis Y and Y distance from axis X. So this G is represented by XY. These are the coordinate of this point where total area is concentrated. And if we want to define the moment of inertia about Y axis, so it should be AX square, because X is the perpendicular distance from Y axis. So moment of inertia about Y axis, that is represented by IYY, and this is equals to AX square. Now if we want to define IXX, so it will be AY square, because perpendicular distance is Y. So here this is the formula of moment of inertia about both the axis, about Y axis and about X axis. And if we want to define the polar moment of inertia, so it will be the summation of IXX plus IYY. So this is the basic concept of moment of inertia. Now here we have to define here mass moment of inertia. So here one term is added, that is mass. So in place of area, we will keep mass value, or here we will replace this area with mass. So mass moment of inertia will be defined as the product of mass into square of the distance between mass center of the body and its axis. So here I we generally define as area into square of the distance, or that particular point where area is concentrated from the reference axis. So here this area we are going to replace with mass, and the rest of the term will be same, multiplied by square of the distance between mass center of the body and its excess. So it should be mass into X square. So here if we are considering mass of this total body or total lamina is M, so in place of A we will write down M, and in place of this X square we will write down the perpendicular distance, or we will write down the square of the distance between mass center and its axis. So here if we are considering G is the mass center where total mass of the object is concentrated, and this X is the distance from this point G to Y axis, or from Y axis to this point G. So here this particular equation will be mx square. Or here, if we want to define from the x-axis, so it will be my square. So only we have to replace area with mass. And now here, let us consider this is a plane lamina or this is a plane object which is having total mass m. Now, if we are dividing this lamina into number of parts, for example, here, if we are considering n number of parts and every part is having mass m1, m2, m3 up to mn. Here, this is the nth part. So, here, this is our first part which is having area m1. For second part, this mass m2. For third part, mass m3. Now, here, we need to define the point where total mass of this part is concentrated. So we will define the point G1 where total mass of this particular part is concentrated, and we need to define the distance of this G1 point from the reference axis. For example, if we are taking y-axis, so let us consider R1 is the distance of this point G1 from y-axis. Similarly, if we are defining the G2, so let us consider distance R2 of this G2 from y-axis. Similarly, for G3, it will be on different height according to mass and area. So let us consider R3. So if we want to define the total mass moment of inertia for this object, so we can define this as the summation of the mass moment of area for each part. So for first part, the mass moment of area will be m1 into square of the perpendicular distance from y-axis. So it will be r1 square. So m1 r1 square. So for this first part, it will be m1 r1 square. For second part, it will be m2 r2 square. For third part, it will be m3 r3 square, and so on up to nth part. So it will be m1 r1 square plus m2 r2 square plus m3 r3 square, and so on up to nth part. So we can write down this as summation of m r square. Let us consider the distance of this point G from y-axis as r. In place of x, we are writing r. And the summation of m is represented as total mass m1 plus m2 plus m3 up to mn. So here, this summation of m r square is representing the total mass moment of inertia for this object or for this lamina. So by this way, we can define the mass moment of inertia of any body or any object which is having mass m. So this is the formula: mass into square of the distance between mass center of the body and axis is representing mass moment of inertia. Now let's define the radius of gyration. So radius of gyration here we will define on the basis of point where the total mass of the object is concentrated. So here we are considering same diagram, a plane or an object with mass m, and here we will consider one point where total mass of the object is concentrated, and we will define the coordinate of this point G from x-axis and y-axis. So it will be gxy. So here we can define radius of gyration. If the total mass of the lamina is concentrated at one point, so let us consider this point is G. So the distance between the point and the given axis is called radius of gyration. So here, if we are considering the given axis is y-axis, and the distance of this point G to up to this y-axis, from y-axis to point G, if we are considering distance x, so this x is represented as the radius of gyration. Now, if we are considering the axis as x, so here we have distance y from G to x-axis. So this y is represented as radius of gyration. But here we will consider rotation of the object. So here we can consider this body is rotating about a point where total mass of the body is concentrated or lamina is concentrated, and this is rotating with respect to one axis. So distance between this axis and that point is called the radius of gyration. And if we are denoting this radius of gyration as k, so here In place of area, we will put m only. So it will be under root of I by m. Or we can write down this I value. It is k square into m. So here, this mass moment of inertia is simple. M into k square. So m is the mass of the object. And k is the distance of this particular point from the reference axis or from the given axis. And about this particular axis with radius k, this body can rotate. That is why it is called radius of gyration. So this is the formula of radius of gyration in terms of mass moment of inertia. Here we will replace mass, or we will replace area with mass. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can rate, review and share this lesson with your friends and your known people. And if you want to watch more lessons related to mechanical engineering, please subscribe the channel.